Well, you actually cannot compare it. One is designed for a robust nature and the other one is a measure of a cost-effective solution. Honestly speaking, there is no comparison between S7-300 and S7-1200 as they are entirely from the different application domains. S7-1200 is a successor of S7-200 PLC. It can only be used with TIA portal software. It is not fast, limited input and output module. It is cost-effective, cheaper in use but slower compared to S7-300 PLCs. S7-1200 microcontroller got limited functionality and expandability. They are intended to use in protected environment with no vibration and clean power. As I told you, S7-1200, the low-end PLC from Siemens, is meant to replace S7-200 series, but there is nothing low-end about the features this PLC provides. Of course, it does everything that any other PLC does, but it also does so much more. The software used to program this PLC is Siemens TIA Portal, the Siemens Totally Integrated Automation Suite. At this time, TIA can program some of the S7-300 and S7-400 processes along with all of the S7-1200 and S7-1500 model. There are some really cool features included with this PLC. One that I have been using recently is the user web pages. A simple HTML page can be designed and reference PLC tags directly on the page. You can also tag back to the PLC from the web page. In a simple program, the web page can actually be used in place of an HMI to give the user interface to the system. Another cool feature is the email function. Email can be sent directly from the PLC. I use this function in my project to notify users of machines problem and send machines reports. S7-300 is more robust in nature and can be expanded to higher levels of IOs. Memory capacity can also be extended to reasonable length. The nature of CPU is designed to handle more complex machines and processes and is suitable in any environmental conditions. It's operable with the Simatic Manager and TIA portal as well. It has got more operable functions than S7-1200. For processes control with several faster control loops, I would use S7-300 or even S7-1500. The S7-1200 would handle smaller application and slower acting control loops. Automation will fall well into the ability of the S7-1200. The S7-1200 has built-in abilities such as high speed counting and motion control. The S7-300 normally needs lots of hardware for that. Distributed control with networked S7-1200 is easier too. At the end of the day, it depends on your application. Putting the differences in the list may help you decide which to use. Have you ever used S7-1200? What do you think about this device and which features do you like the most? Please write your opinion in the comment section. If you want to know what are the best and top PLC brand in the world, I recommend that you do not miss this video. In this video, we thoroughly examine the top 5 companies in terms of revenue and position in the automation field. First, like now and then go watch this fantastic video. Take care and see you soon.